And I'll be ready.
Okay. Hi everyone, thank you all for being here today. My name is Maddie and this is my senior project. So my essential question is, what are the steps needed to create a documentary about body image issues in the dance community, and how can I educate the Mills community on this topic? So in this presentation, I'll first be going over the inspiration behind my project and how I chose my mentor, process of my project and the different steps that I took, some different challenges that I faced and how I overcame them, and lastly, just reflecting on my whole project and different takeaways and feedback that I got from this year. So first off, why I chose this project, one of the many things is my background in dance. I've been dancing my whole life. I've always loved it. It's kind of like one of the things that I'm known for, so I just thought that would be a fun element to add in my senior project. The other thing is, this year I took one of Miss Manion's high school classes, like the first time I ever taking over high school courses, and I've always wanted to, but I was always like too afraid to. But after like a couple classes of being in it, I like shortly like developed her love of film, because she's so passionate about it. And then lastly, my connection with body image issues and just like self-image. I always love those topics and the conversations surrounding that, but I've always like wanted to hear from like, the dancer side. I feel like that isn't talked about enough. So I thought with my background and my interest in both things that I'd be a good person for that. So once I knew that I wanted to do a project surrounding film, I knew instantly that I wanted this lady, and that's my mentor. She has so much experience in the film industry. She also has so many tools in her classroom with film, so I knew she'd be able to walk me through that and learn how to use them. But not only does she have all of this experience and all of these resources, she's just a very kind individual, not just as a teacher, but just as a person. So I know that she would be giving me all the support and be very kind to me throughout this whole year. So the process of my senior project, I started in October with researching and organizing my film. Then in November, I did all of my filming and scheduling when I would film. Then December through January, I spent editing, learning how to edit, and then doing something called a brain trust, which I'll go into a little bit later. And then lastly, my film was done in February when I was just uploading it. And then I also took part in Andrew Marr's Senior Project Day, which I'll go into here. So first off, one of the main things that I research is how to organize a film, specifically a documentary, because that's what I wanted to do. So I learned that all the documentaries sort of fit into sort of a narrative structure, so that means having a story and a three-act structure, so beginning, middle, end. Documentaries usually have different types of stories, which are either like they're either goal-oriented, issue-oriented, or focusing on a sort of like journey and transformation of some sort. And what I also learned is a lot of filmmakers, in order to keep their film organized and like clean, they create a storyboard where they basically like write and map out what shots they want and what scenes they want and where, basically. Another thing that I researched was body image, specifically in dancers, and I just learned some key elements to why dancers can develop such poor body image. One of the things is body and ballet aesthetics. So like dancers, typically ballerinas, as we know, are sort of expected to be very skinny and thin. And tying that into social media, you know, our society as a whole really obsesses over sort of like the hourglass or curvy look. So for dancers to have to fit like a very skinny and then also a very like hourglass curvy body, and they're two completely different body types, you know, that can be frustrating. And then lastly, different body shapes come more natural to some people than others just because of genetics and just, you know, our DNA, we cannot control that. So, yeah, having like one body shape, you know, when you want another, that can be frustrating as well. So, going into my interviews, I really wanted my research to reflect in my questions that I asked. Before I started writing the questions, though, I began finding people to interview. I interviewed both dancers and non-dancers. Dancers, that was easy. I was just able to reach out to some, like a lot of my friends who dance, and then also one of my dance teachers who was really interested in being interviewed, which I loved. And then non-dancers, I was just able to find people in my TV class, which was a huge help. And so then, once I had my people and my questions, I was able to schedule when to film these things. For dancers, I was able to film at the Mills Indian Dance Theater. And then I was just able to film during my TV class with help with Ms. Mannion in the auditorium. So after all of my filming was done, I then moved into the editing process. I edited with Adobe Premiere Pro, which was a lot more intimidating than just editing on iMovie. But I got a lot of help from Ms. Mannion. She really held my hand through it all, showed me all of these tutorials when I was learning. And I also planned out when I would be editing, so I had like almost every single day when I had TV, I was able to work during then. But I was also able to take the laptop that I was using to edit outside of school or during my study or during FlexBlock, so I'm really grateful for all of that time that I had to work on it. So when my film was in sort of like the rough draft sort of stage, I did something with my TV class, which is called Brain Trust. This is a method originally used at Pixar that we used in Ms. Mannion's class. And it's basically when a filmmaker just gathers a small group of people that they feel comfortable with. They show a rough draft of their film to this audience, and they just get the audience's any ideas, any thoughts, any feedback that they have. So that's what I did with the people in my TV class. I'm really grateful for using my peers just because they had all been first-time filmmakers too, so they get the struggle. They get, you know, that it's going to be flawed. So yeah. And then once I had all of their ideas and their thoughts, I was able to incorporate that into finishing up final edits, and then I was, you know, done with my documentary. So a couple challenges that I faced during this whole year. One was getting people to interview. I was able to like communicate to people like, hey, like, do you want to be interviewed? And I had a lot of people coming back to me like, oh my gosh, yes, that would be so cool. And then, you know, people started flaking, or, you know, people started getting more busy, which I totally get. Another thing is technical issues. I originally planned on filming with one of Ms. Mannion's, like, you know, very professional cameras. And then, of course, that broke. I swear it was not my fault. So I just filmed on my iPhone. I just resorted to that and ended up working out. And then last thing is I just made a lot of mistakes during the editing process, which I kind of anticipated because it was a whole new platform that I never used before, and it did take me a while to learn. I was just kind of making mistake after mistake. But I'm very grateful for Ms. Mannion and also other people in my TV class who were able to help me along the way, who were a little bit more knowledgeable about Adobe Premiere than I was. So though I experienced a good amount of challenges, I did get a lot of feedback, a lot of positive awards from this. I started getting some emails like these from teachers I hadn't really had in a while, who were just reaching out to me randomly after my film was uploaded and was like, hey, like, I saw your film, that was great. And I also started getting lots of like texts and like from friends, like people I don't really talk to that much, just being like, hey, like, that was awesome what you did, it really resonated with me. So that was sort of just reassurance for me that like what I did, what I created, you know, I got my message out, you know, the message that I wanted to get out. So adding to this, I also presented during Andrew Marr's senior project day. So me and a couple other people who had film-based senior projects, we just showed them to all of the grades, and that was very scary at first. I remember like a couple days beforehand getting a text from Ms. Mannion, and she was like, hey, you're gonna show your documentary, and I really want to text back. Hey, no. But I did it, and I'm very glad that I did it, because I just got even more positive feedback from it. I got a lot of people coming up to me at the end being like, hey, like, that was amazing. I really, like, you know, I connect with what you were also talking about. So, I'm very grateful for that. So I just want to give a special thanks to my mentor, Ms. Mannion, all of the dancers who I interviewed, so Angela Cole, Kate Ewald, Amari Sharma, Lindsay Surratt, and also all of the non-dancers from my KU3 TV class. And then also the Millis and Eden Dance Theater for letting me be able to use their studio for filming. This is my website. And any questions?